Aquateam was created to help kids explore the ocean.
We've done months of training.
We've been learning from the most amazing ocean experts.
But to earn our tickets to underwater adventure, we've got to prove our skills in the open ocean.
It's time to get certified.
Place in the world, not the Bahamas.
Welcome to the Bahamas. 6 weeks you've been training for this day, and it's finally here.
Yeah.
Today, you're gonna dive in the open ocean. These are not leisurely dives. These are your certification dives. You must complete all tasks correctly in order to pass and become certified open water divers. If you are successful, you will become members of the Aquateam, and over the next 3 months, you'll get the chance to dive in search of lost treasure. Explore sunken shipwrecks and see some of the most amazing creatures on the planet. Everybody ready?
Yeah!
First, you have to pass. Okay. Let's get suited up and let's go to our dive site.
Today we're getting certified in the ocean and we're gonna have to do a couple things like lift up our masks off and pull them away and then put them back on and clear them.
We're having our first certification dive in like real open water, not in a pool. So we're gonna be seeing real fish and not like hair elastics and bobby pins at the bottom of the pool.
And we are going to take what we've learned from the classroom and apply it to open water diving. And have fun while we're doing it, you know what I mean?
I sound like really nasally.
Before we were only about 3 feet, 4 feet underwater. But now we're gonna be doing everything 20 feet underwater. It should be fine, no problem, but there's still a few things that will be a little bit scary.
I've never been really on a boat before, so.
Really?
We all really want to pass.
Yeah.
And since we don't pass,
that's not good.
It's just not good.
We have to pass these tests, and if we don't pass, then we won't become members of the Aquateam.
It's really, really hard.
Let's help them back.
The biggest challenge today is going to be not getting seasick.
We were just like eating lunch and I just randomly felt like really sick to my stomach and I threw up like all of my lunch and it was kind of nasty and I wasn't even like on the boat. Yeah.
She threw up half of her burger on the other half of her burger.
I'm still good. I'm gonna work through it.
Somebody already threw up and we're not even on the water yet.
When I'm on land, I feel like I'm rocking.
Don't even want to know what's in store for her when she gets on the boat. I heard the waves are supposed to get worse in the afternoon.
A lot of cool stuff is in store for us.
Oh, yeah.
Classroom stuff's all fun and all, but being in the ocean, it's all real now.
One person throws up, everyone else starts to think they're gonna throw up.
Emily?
Is it gonna be all right to dive?
I think so.
She's thrown up about 5 times now. She says she's gonna go. I'm not sure she's gonna be okay. I think so. We'll see.
Divers! We're finally here, and this is it. We are gonna dive today, and this is your certification dives. You must pass all your skills. Remember that. All right, pay very close attention. Remember what you've learned in the pool. It's exactly the same stuff.
All right,
I'm now gonna hand you off to your dive instructor that you know well. Pat?
We've already assembled our gear, so we're going to put the gear on. And our buddy pairs, we're gonna do a pre-dive safety check, and then we're gonna enter the water.
What lessons are we doing today?
That's the lesson. First dive is a tour, and we're gonna swim around, we're gonna look at some pretty things. Let's put our gear on, Aquateam. Yes.
When we dive, we always work in buddy pairs.
Yeah.
That way it's so much safer, and you always have a friend with you to share the experience.
This is actually the first time me ever getting off the boat in the middle of an ocean.
In the pool, there weren't any currents, right?
Yeah.
These currents are pretty strong today.
You feel a little bit better?
I feel a little bit better, but yeah,
can
I'm
you dive?
Still gonna try to do the dive.
You know what you're doing, right?
Yeah, I don't have one.
Okay.
It's funny, I had three in the pool too, and now I have four.
To break this heart, ooh, are you coming?
Ooh, here you go.
Where are you going? All I really want to know is which way the wind is blowing.
This is amazing! Woohoo!
I'm really sad that I didn't get to like go in the water and do stuff with everybody else, because I really don't feel good.
I want to dream and then I want to wake up. I want to break, but I don't want to break up. I want a song, I don't want to have to sing it. I want your love right now. Did you bring it? Did you bring it?
I had to go back on the boat and wait until they were finished their dive and just like sit on the boat.
I think I'm just gonna lay down and close my eyes.
I did see one stingray and it just kind of swam by us, didn't really care. I think everybody was extremely like amazed about how everything was just like really blue.
Spectacular. More fish than I've ever seen in my whole life.
That was so cool. Oh my goodness. There are like fishes everywhere and they're all like really cool.
It was just so cool that they come up to you and swim like inches from your face.
And then me and Kumi were like just swimming along, we saw a stingray and we freaked, so we had to hold hands the rest of the way.
I was just swimming along and then this fish pooped right on my head. It was kind of weird, but other than that, it was amazing.
The whole time we were down there, it was 20 feet, and that's the depth that we're going to be doing all of our tasks. And I'm totally comfortable down there, so I feel like nothing would go wrong.
All right, everybody, how was that?
It was great.
That was good. That was our first dive of our checkout dives.
Yep.
The most important part for this one is to get these skills done. I'll be doing these individually with you, and I don't want anybody doing this until I'm right there in front of you.
So I just missed out on the first dive and I'm really still not feeling that good. So I'm gonna probably miss out on the second dive now. I'm really sad that I can't go in the water. And I guess if I don't, I won't get to be a member of the Aquateam, and that would really suck.
The Aquateam's mission is to teach kids about the ocean and the underwater world. To become part of the Aquateam, we need to pass our certification dives. But I'm so seasick, I'm not sure if I'm gonna be able to do it.
Emily and I were dive buddies today, but Emily got kind of sick on the boat and she threw up a couple times. She even threw up before we were on the boat. So now we're kind of just hoping to see if maybe she can do the next dive.
Good luck, everybody. This is dive number two. Okay. Second dive, we're going to make you work a little bit now.
You know, it's sad to see one of your aqua team members not be able to go down because of sickness.
So I'm going to try to do the second dive now so I can catch up.
We all were kind of in the water and we looked up and she was like gearing on and we all kind of like cheered because she was putting her wetsuit on and we're like, she's going to come in. Yes.
Once we get in our water in our buddy pairs, we're gonna do a tired diver toe.
On the surface, we did the tired diver toe, which is when if one of your divers is tired, you can tow them back to the boat.
Tow your buddy for 25 meters. Use any one of those methods that we showed you before, whichever one's your favorite. Then you're gonna switch, and the other person is gonna tow their buddy then for another 25 meters. Out of the ordinary,
come on and dance with me. The CSIS, the controlled emergency ascent. I screwed that up the first time, but I did the second time pretty well. It's important not to go up too fast. A good guideline is to not go up past your bubble. If you do, you could get the bends or decompression symptoms, which is really deadly.
Do a regulator recovery. So what you do, take a nice breath, let it drop, and I want to see bubbles coming out of you. Anytime there's no regulator in your mouth, you'll be exhaling continuously. Reach back as far as you can, do a nice wide sweep, and you'll recover your hose somewhere along your arm. Put your regulator back in your mouth, clear it. Take a cautious breath, make sure you get some air, and then okay signal.
Some sleep and bring on Aquateam. Yes.
The resort's awesome. We're all becoming great friends. We're having a great time.
We're learning more about the ocean every day. We're here in the Bahamas, and I can't wait to see some of these creatures in the wild.
Aquamission, here I come.
Open up the party, never end.
Let's get suited up. Let's go. This is the roughest day. I understand, but we gotta get it done. So let's go, let's go.
So do you want us to suit up?
Definitely. You gotta like consider what'll happen if you don't complete all the tasks correctly, but I think we're pretty confident.
Yeah.
I think we can do it.
Absolutely. I'm confident in everyone here.
Teamwork rocks.
Yeah, it's pretty important. If you run out of air, you need a buddy or you could die.
You have one dive left. You must pass all these skills today. You've been doing really well so far. Just a few more skills left to do, and then we'll become members of the Aquateam. Is everybody ready?
Yeah!
The skill that I'm kind of worried about is the mask budding, just because I'm already having so much trouble with the salt water like in my nose and everywhere.
Gonna kick ourselves up into a hover position, so you should be able to hover just off the bottom for about 30 seconds without moving your hands or kicking your feet or anything like that, using breath control only. When your light turns green. Next one we're gonna do mask remove and replace. Slide your mask, take it right off, put it on and clear it.
See, well, you could keep your eyes open, but it stings because of the salt water. So you're best off closing your eyes, then you won't be able to see.
It was pretty bad because the salt would get in your eyes and you'd like try and blink really hard and you'd try to like cry it away, but you got over it, it just burned.
Fish around you, but this time we actually had like a bottle of food and we would hold it up so some of the food would come out, and we were swarmed by fish. So you had a fish like right in front of you and it was amazing.
Right like that, there's like 100 fish all in front of your face. You told us in front of us all, and fish everywhere as you couldn't even see. It's awesome.
I don't feel seasick down here at all. It's too bad I have to go back up to the boat, but I have to find out if I've made it onto the Aquateam. We've just finished our first open water dives to prove our skills as divers. I hope we all did well enough to become members of the Aquateam. Everyone did really great, and they didn't get seasick.
Oh my God. It feels so good. Oh my gosh, I'm so happy it's all done.
Didn't think I'd be able to make it all the way down to the bottom, but I did. Good job, Emily! Woo!
I think the more times we do it, the less the salt water bugs me. Like, I'm used to it in my eyes now.
Our instructor was like taking off his mask and looking at
like
it.
Had it, and then
in my head, I was just like, doesn't that hurt? Fish is better here.
You better get this on, Tate.
Oh, hey, I don't know them.
Welcome. You've just gotten back from your last certification dive. And I've heard from your dive instructors that you've all done really well. Congratulations. As I call your name, step forward and I will hand you a certificate that makes you certified open water divers and members of the Aquateam. Kumbi. Congratulations. You are now a member of the Aquateam. Nick. Congratulations. Gwyneth. Congratulations. Isabel. Congratulations. Joseph. Congratulations. You are now a member of the Aquateam. Rachel. Congratulations. Jordan. Congratulations. You are now a member of the Aquateam. And Emily. Congratulations. You are now all members of the Aquateam.
Crazy creep.